You might have heard about a particularly dangerous insect in the news over the last few years. The name makes them almost sound charming. Spotted lanternflies. It sounds like they'd be fireflies with adorable Dalmatian spots. And they are actually kind of pretty. They have yellow bumblebee-like stripes on their bodies and red hind wings with black spots. But when they are outside of their native range, spotted lanternflies are anything but charming, because they are yet another invasive species that could cause a lot of harm to the environment and to our food supply if they continue to spread. So let's talk about these pretty little insects and why they pose such a huge threat. Spotted lanternflies, also known as Lycorma delicatula, are originally from China, Japan, and Vietnam. But these bugs have started to expand outside of their native range to places like South Korea and way outside their range into the US. And they haven't actually been here very long. Spotted lanternfly eggs probably first arrived in 2012 in a shipment of cut stone. But they've made the most of that time. In just their first 12 years here, they have already spread to at least 14 states. The spotted lanternfly's preferred food is the tree of heaven, which, despite the name, isn't a very heavenly sort of tree. For one thing, these trees are also invasive in the United States and cause a lot of problems for our local biomes. In the US, groves of this tree of heaven rapidly crowd out native plants, and they can even produce chemicals that ensure other plants can't compete with them for resources. Female trees of heaven can produce more than 300,000 seeds a year, so this is clearly a plant bent on world domination. So you would think having something around that eats that tree would be a good thing, but unfortunately that has not proved to be the case. Because the tree of heaven is so prolific, it ends up helping to facilitate the spread of spotted lanternflies, since they can just bop into whatever territory the trees have already invaded. The spotted lanternfly normally kicks off its life cycle on this tree. It lays eggs in the fall, the adults die in the winter, and the eggs hatch in the spring. But the thing is, unlike some other bugs that are adapted to a particular host plant, spotted lanternflies can eat and lay eggs on other things too. They don't need the tree of heaven to complete their life cycle. And as we've already established, these eggs don't even need to be on, like, a plant. Sometimes they're on cut stones, which is how they got here. Manufactured items like campers, barbecue grills, and outdoor furniture are all at risk of being unwitting lanternfly nurseries. And these little guys are bloodsuckers. Kinda. They're phloem feeders, which means they eat sap. They're tree bloodsuckers. Because sap is basically plant blood, and when it leaks out, it hardens into a kind of scab to protect the wounds on the plant's surface. So, to get their favorite snack flowing, these bugs have to damage the outside of their host plant, which leaves them vulnerable to infections. And then, there's the honeydew, and I do not mean the melon. Because the spotted lanternfly's diet is high in sugar, their waste is also sweet. It's so sweet that scientists call it honeydew. And despite its pleasant name and not unpleasant taste, it is nasty stuff. The sugars in the waste encourage the growth of mold, which is not something you want happening on your crops. And yes, aside from the tree of heaven, they love to chow down on our food crops. Stuff people depend on, like corn, grapes, and soybeans, as well as non-edible but still important plants like trees for timber. Corn and soybeans are the two biggest crops in the United States, and they also happen to be some major spotted lanternfly targets, which means these insects have the potential to threaten major food supply chains for all of us. In Pennsylvania, experts think spotted lanternflies may cost the state's agriculture and logging industries around $500 million annually, at least in their worst-case scenario. And spotted lanternflies have only been in Pennsylvania since 2014, so they can start causing mayhem pretty quickly. As with all invasive species, controlling spotted lanternflies is going to be challenging, but there is still hope. So it turns out that there's a crucial time of year when spotted lanternflies are sitting ducks. Since adults die out in the winter, there are always a few months of the year where there aren't any more of them laying eggs, and the eggs they have produced are vulnerable and squishable. This makes manual egg removal a partial strategy, though it's a bit like playing whack-a-mole, which means that researchers are pretty invested in finding efficient ways to find these eggs. One of the cutest potential solutions is scent hounds, which can be trained to detect the eggs so a human can then squish them. Less cute, but still a decent alternative, people can be trained to find the eggs. The tree of heaven is the first place you should look, since that's their favorite snack. It's easy to spot the egg masses, which are about 1 inch long and resemble a dull brown mud smear. Experts also say that anybody who spots a lanternfly's telltale spots in their area should report them to the US Department of Agriculture's Animal and Plant Health Inspection Service, or your local agency with an invasive species council. Once the lanternflies are found, those agencies can use eradication methods like pesticides and sticky traps, though always these come with a risk of capturing native beneficial insects. Other researchers are developing biopesticides that specifically target spotted lanternflies or recruiting their natural enemies, such as a fungus that can colonize the spotted lanternfly. As with other invasive species, especially in the earliest days, diligence is key. And that is what you need to know about the spotted lanternfly. While they are just the latest in a long line of problematic invasive species, it's worth knowing about them because we are still in a position to control the spread of this one. So if you spot these troublesome spots near you, now you know what to do.